Hi, I'm Suzanne Spy with AtlasRFIDStore.com, and we are here with Ed Nabrowski from OmniID. We're here at the booth. How are you doing, Ed?
We're doing fantastic. We've had a great show.
Oh, great. I know. RFID Journal Live has just been awesome. I heard you got some new stuff at OmniID. What's been going on at the booth here?
Oh, we've had a lot of traffic, a lot of visitors. We've got quite a lot of our staff down to handle that volume, but it's been nonstop ever since the show opened. We're nominated for Best in Show again this year. We've got Coolest Demo. We've got a lot of different things, so it's really exciting for us.
Great. Well, you have to show us around, show us what y'all are doing, and of course that demo, we got to see it.
Sure, we'll show it to you. The booth is divided up into five basic sections. We'll start with this section, which is our energy industry section, a lot about our pipe tracking and different on-metal applications. I'll show this to you really quickly. One of the things we do a lot of is tool tracking. You can see some of the on-metal tools, on-metal tags we do right on the tools. This shows a non-encased version on a wrench, which allows us to get tremendous read range. Using the wrench as an antenna, we can get out to 5-6 meters of read right off of the metal tool.
Wow.
So it's a fantastic application for us. In fact,
is that the 210?
This is the 210,
that's
right.
That's what I thought, yeah.
That's right.
We sell a lot of those.
You do, and they're a fantastic product for us. We sell them in different applications, both as a retrofit like this, or as an OEM application directly in a tool. In fact, if I walk you around the side here, I don't know how mobile we are.
We are very mobile. Wherever you want to go, we're behind you.
This is an example of the 210, and this is it in one of our manufactured in applications. You see the 210 here completely encased with the rubber grip over the top.
And you wouldn't even tell it was there.
You can't even tell it's there. It's such a thin format, and yet it gets such great read range because it's coming right off of the tool. It's been made for that type of embedded application.
Great, and that's a good on-metal tool, I'm guessing. So that's good for in the workplace, asset tracking, tool tracking, that kind of thing.
Absolutely. Yeah, you don't have to use it just on tools. Obviously, you can use it on different metal cages, different bars. But for tool tracking, it's absolutely fantastic.
Great.
Now, this demo is supposed to show when a wrench is removed. Someone's walked away with one of the wrenches because they wanted to show it to someone, and so it's constantly on red. But typically, this is showing how you can walk up and manage a tool crib using our on-metal tools.
Oh, great. Tool tags. Okay, great. Mm-hmm. Well, what else is going on? It's so much stuff everywhere.
There is. Why don't we try and angle you here so you can come in this direction.
Okay.
This is actually one of our, this is our Best in Show nomination, which is our on-metal tags, our IQ tags. This happens to be the IQ600. It's the only on-metal RFID tag certified through Zebra Printers. And so that's a really significant thing for us, and one of the reasons we're nominated for Best in Show for this product. We're also showing a few other formats with different printers as well. A lot of press has been out about this already. I think you might have even blogged about it for us.
Oh, definitely. Definitely. We love blogging about OmniID. Great tags.
We certainly hope so. So it's fantastic to be able to print right on site and still be able to slap it directly onto metal or onto liquid. I think we have a liquid cylinder there that's showing the tag directly on top of it. We've had some major applications with blood bags in healthcare, for instance, but also on all sorts of metal products in industrial and even in military for this product. So we hope we'll win Best in Show. Vote for us if you're here. You get a chance to vote.
Exactly. I think you're the first one we got nominated on here.
We'll show you one application of that, actually. This is a specialty version. This is a project we did for a particular obvious OEM that's here. And instead of their typical metal plate that they've got, they've used one of those IQ formats directly here to identify their motor. And that allows them to go through manufacturing. Pull this out. We'll zoom in. So much cheaper than an engraved plate, and of course giving us read range to be able to identify it as it's going through their process or being shipped out their back door or even at the customer site. It gives them a permanent RFID on metal presentation of the ID of the motor.
And all these products so far, are they already out? Are they coming out?
Already out.
Already
these are
out.
Shippable today, and we've been shipping them in already pretty good quantities. I think also through your store.
Yes, definitely.
We sell these in rolls, of course, and it can go right through your printer, just like a standard roll label, and they're available today.
And I notice you have another tag right here.
Yeah, we're using this to show a few other things, and so I don't know if I can remove these. I think they're stuck down. This is another one of our tags that's made for tool tracking primarily, but it also goes on any other metal component. Our biggest market for this has been in tool rental. So you'll open up the case of a drill or an impact hammer and just drop this inside, and then you can track that tool coming in and out of the rental shops.
Oh, great.
So it's been fantastic, but you can use it for anything else on metal. It's a good on metal embedded tag encased for durability.
And you can see it sticks pretty well.
It does stick really well. I can't even take it off. I think these are all stuck down.
Oh.
This has been a real popular tag for us. This is our frack pipe tag. You may have been aware in the market of how fracking has become a huge application in the U.S. It's a regulated industry, and tracking those pipes is really important. Caustic slurry is pushed down the pipes, and it actually eats the pipe from the inside out. And so the government requires those pipe manufacturers and people that are doing the drilling to track their pipe to know how often it's been used, whether it needs to be reconditioned or replaced before it can go down the hole. Obviously, environmental disasters are a problem. This tag's been made to be banded and to go around the outside. It's incredibly durable. 300-pound sledgehammer blows won't affect this tag. and yet you get tremendous read ranges and consistency in the tag. So this has been specifically made for pipe tracking, and it's one of our featured products, new in show, is our pipe tracking tag.
Yeah, I think we've sold some of those recently, actually. When I'm looking at them, I'm thinking, yeah, I've definitely seen those around. So
they've been around. We started them this last year, so they're maybe a half a year, 8 months old. Okay. We're actually on a second generation. We've cost-reduced them and toughened them up a little bit with some new manufacturing techniques and some new epoxy on the inside. But they're a great tag. We sell a lot of them.
All right, well, what else do we have going on?
Well, let's show you a few other things. I'll show you something a little more advanced. And this show is one of our IQ labels, by the way, right on a water jug.
Oh, fabulous, okay.
Again, another application that you can't do with a standard RFID label, but you can do with our IQ labels.
And that was right out of that Zebra printer,
right
too.
Out of the Zebra printer. This one wasn't printed, we put it unprinted on, but yes, it'll go right through that printer.
Okay, great.
Now this is something a little bit new, so I'll be happy to show this to you. This is we thought we'd bring our advanced prototypes along. We have two customers that we're building specialty versions for this for. This will never be an off-the-shelf product because of its nature, but it's a really exciting technology. This is a battery-free display tag. Now, you've seen our visual tagging that we launched last year. It won Best in Show at this event last year. Fantastic product that's getting great uptick, and I'll show you more about that. This one happens to have no battery at all. It harvests with this inverted F antenna that's on here. It harvests the energy from an RFID reader, uses that energy to update an e-ink segmented display. You can see the display is flexible plastic. Gives you that ability to be able to create bended surfaces or to have incredibly durable performance in an industrial environment and yet still be able to get a printable surface. In effect, this is another generation of this. This is a changeable electronic RFID tag that can go anywhere for you. And with no battery, it's completely passive.
Fabulous.
I'm going to see if I can update it for you while you're filming through this antenna here.
Okay.
Just to show you what it looks like. There's different segments. So you write it through any standard RFID reader, and as soon as we send the image to it, it's harvesting the energy from the write, and then it changes the screen to be the number that we want. This allows you to print labels dynamically through goods going through your process and change it with a tag without using paper, no consumables, very environmentally friendly, and still get all the tracking characteristics of RFID plus the visual characteristics of bistable screens.
So is this reusable? Can this be put on many different things, reused different a cycle of manufacturing,
yep.
That kind of stuff?
Absolutely. And that's what it's made for. We have large sortation customers that want to use it on cycling racks, cycling totes, and then reuse it every time through the cycle. So
that's cost
it'll last for years
too, especially for the customer. So that's great.
Absolutely. So it's an extension of our visual tagging line. Let me take you around the side and I'll tell you more about visual tagging. So let me tell you a little bit about visual tagging. Again, it was Best in Show winner last year. We're fantastically proud of that award. But even more proud than that award is the customers that have adopted this technology with us. We're in major automotive manufacturers, appliance manufacturers, different aerospace technology companies using visual tagging now. And we think it's going to be a significant revolution in the industry. So our demo here shows, for instance, a 3-inch tag on a typical tote. This is where they'll often live. They'll be
set. Plastic.
Plastic, yep. They can be plastic or metal. It really doesn't matter where they're on. This bin is our competition is to guess how many of these Kanban cards are in here. So a typical card like this is usually printed and stuck on the side of the bin in a cyclic process. These tags replace those cards and allow all of that information to be stored in multiple pages of the display so that as it goes through, it displays only the information the operator needs to know. A lot of advantages, of course, to having a dynamic surface versus a static piece of paper. Some of the advantages include being able to put on a quality hold, for instance.
Right.
Rather than go out with a crayon and mark across on hold or put a little red tag, you can send an electronic signal to the screen and put a Ghostbuster symbol through it and say, don't use me.
Right.
One of our customers specifically bought the technology for that purpose, to improve their accuracy and speed of quality holds.
Oh, great.
This one I've implemented with a magnetic switch just to show, so you can see some of the messaging. We can turn the pages with a magnet in this case, but those pages would normally turn through an RFID scan or through a command through the active radio. But here we put some messaging to show, you know, what's the story of visual tagging, why is it important. some of the things you can see is that workers can see what they need to do directly on the asset. So as this tote goes through a process, it could go to the paint room, for instance, and the worker will be told, paint me blue. So this batch of parts has to be painted blue. And then really exciting thing is, because you're tracking it through RFID, you can track that action and say, yes, this was painted, and show a visual confirmation on the surface of the screen.
This is really cool.
It's really cool. You know, one of the things I'm excited about and our customers get excited about is that we've always heard RFID is 98%, 96% effective going through portals. You sometimes miss some scans. When you add the visual element, it means that you poke-yoke or idiot-proof your process.
Right.
Even if you miss the scan, visually your worker will see that it didn't flip the page.
Right.
And now you can increment it yourself, update the system. You're guaranteed by the time it gets to the next step, it has been entered in the system, because it's impossible to get to the next step without it being scanned.
So just making it 100% effective, basically.
Making it 100% effective and doing it without paper and doing it automatically, so your workers don't have to carry around extra tablets, handhelds. It's right here on the asset where you're supposed to be.
Right.
As the message on this screen says, it's also really green. This is the amount of paper that one of these tags will replace.
Wow.
And when we first went into our first customer pitching this concept, we actually took a whole pile of these and dumped them on the boardroom table. And we asked, he said, what's that? And I said, well, that's the amount of paper you generated this shift on tagging your totes. In that case, we had 890,000 of these cards being generated in that plant they had 120,000 being generated every day in their supply chain.
Oh my God.
Which is a lot of trees being cut down just to label cycling containers.
Exactly.
So when you've got a cyclic process especially, there's a significant green effect on visual tagging.
Well, that's great.
So let's show you the demo.
Great for RFID.
So we're going to show you visual tagging in action on a very compressed scale.
Okay.
Bobic, do you want to run us through, since you're there?
Yeah.
So you can see we've got a Welcome to RFID Journal Live as
all
our
right.
initial screen. And as he scans it going through, he's got his semi-automated system. It's Bavik automated.
Okay, now I see.
Right.
It's a Kanban card, and then it's flipped back to page one.
Mm-hmm. Wow, okay.
So it triggers when it passes through the passive antennas.
Right.
It triggers the active system. It changes the screen. It flips from page one to page two. And then after, like, you know, I have timed it for like 5 to 10 seconds, it changes back to page one, the home page.
Oh, great. Yep. Okay, so you know when it's passed through. Like
exactly.
You were saying, eliminates non-scans or, you know, ineffective situations.
Right. So, for instance, if this tag was coming in off a boat from China, and it was coming in through my cross-dock, as soon as it comes through my portal doorway to be received, all the pages could flip to say, take me now to lineside address number 42. If I'm breaking apart that pallet as a worker, and I'm breaking it apart, and I see one hasn't flipped, and it still is saying, delivering me to plant number such and such, I'll know that I have to hand scan it or manually scan it. And if I don't hand scan it, it won't tell me the destination address of where I'm supposed to deliver it.
So you can't even move forward.
I can't move forward. I've got to set it as an exception, set it aside.
Right.
But that means I've definitely got a closed system that has to work to be able to move it through the visual process.
That is amazing.
Back in the 70s, when we tried to revolutionize our manufacturing, we learned the Japanese had a system called Kanban that we modified, Six Sigma, just in time, lean, you know, different terms we used, but it was all about visual information in front of the worker who used it, using a visual signal to tell me when I have to do an action, take a next step. This is really the next generation of RFID that lets you see visual signals tell me, take me to the paint room, take me line side, return me, I'm empty.
Right.
And it's really an efficient way to manage your process.
Wow, I can see how it won Best in Show then.
Yes, we think so too.
That's a great product.
Yeah.
And it's great to meet you, Ed, and talk to you. I hope that RFID Journal is fabulous for you guys. And you can tell the booth is super busy. Anything, any parting words?
Just keep adopting RFID, buy more tags. It's a fantastic technology, and we're really excited about the upswing in business for everyone in the market. So
great, we love OmniID, so thank you so much.
And we love Atlas. Have a good show.